great location. Most of the lands are still in public ownership, which is a huge, offers huge potential for the City and Waterfront Toronto to work together because we don't have to expropriate. And then one thing that we do know is we're near to Union Station and we're near to this LRT station that's being built, so there's a natural synergy for bringing higher order transit between those two hubs. We have existing recreational spaces, some of them which we've just built recently, for instance, the parks that I mentioned. And then finally, right at the center, at the heart of this Portlands area, we have Pinewood Studios. So we already have creative industries coming down there. To the west, in East Bayfront, we already have Chorus Entertainment, and then, of course, George Brown Health Sciences, which will be on facing right on to Sherman Common. So that's those are great catalysts for moving the neighborhood forward when we have our flood protection. So there's the land ownership map. It shows the, everything that's not yellow is in some level of public ownership, whether it's provincial, municipal, or federal. And then over to you.
So why are we doing this work? Well, on September 21st, City Council endorsed a protocol that directed city staff, Waterfront Toronto, and the Toronto Region Conservation Authority, with input from TPLC, who's the major landowner in the Portlands, to develop a business and implementation plan for the Portlands and to review options for the Don Mau VA. So that's really the direction that we have at this stage in the project. Since that time, starting in October, staff started working together in working groups to try to identify the issues and work towards trying to put some conclusion on some of these issues. And we've also worked with quite a number of specialized consultants on that. And through this process, we had public consultation early on December 12th. We've also assembled a stakeholder advisory committee with approximately 42 members who have different backgrounds, who basically provide feedback on this information on a regular basis. There's also a landowners and a port users advisory committee who brings their own perspective as well and gets to see the same information. So what are the next steps? At the end of April, our consultants will complete their draft report and provide their recommendations to the City, Waterfront Toronto, and the TRCA. When that report comes forward, there'll be another consultation period, similar to this, where those findings will be presented and discussed. And on June 12th, the City staff will forward the report along with their own report to the Executive Committee with recommendations for how to move forward. And that's a key date because you will be able to give deputations to the councils at that time. If that report moves forward from Executive Committee, it should go to Council on July 11th and 12th. And then the final date is October 28th when the pause that the Donmouth EA is currently under expires. So we do need to go back and deal with that before that.
So just to explain what that pause means, as I mentioned before, that the key to unlocking all of this is to get that approval for the Don Mau VA. And what that would require is that in the staff report, the City Council recommends that the Don Mau VA be basically submitted for approval. So those are the key dates, and those are the kind of brackets around them. And any questions? So the long way of saying this is the Don Mau naturalization and Portland's flood protection. So in other words, there's an environmental assessment, which is basically like doing a design but having the public there watching you while you're designing it. Basically, that's what it is. You kind of look at all your problems and opportunities and you make a statement that's called the problem and opportunity statement. Then you look at all the ways of solving that problem, opportunity, not. And you come up with alternatives. You go back to the public again, you say, look, I think these are the three ways I can fix this flood protection issue. Which one do you like best? And then you get input, and then you go back and you say, okay, this is the preferred one for all these reasons based on our feedback and based on our technical research. And then the final is you do an impact assessment where you say, okay, we decided this was the best, but why is it the best? Let's really make sure that we've done our due diligence and that we can actually pull this off. How do we dig this river? You know, what is the contamination in the way? What are the issues that we need to resolve to make sure it'll work? And that's the impact assessment. When you do that, those are your four stages of the environmental assessment, and then you're ready to submit it to the ministry and hope that they accept it. We did that in December of 2010. We submitted it. So we went through all those processes. And then there was an objection to it. And so the ministry said, go on pause. We did. We met with the objectors. We came out with a resolution that everybody agreed to. We put an amendment in. And that was early 2011. Then there was a question about, well, how can you financially do this? What's the economic model for this? That came from the proponents themselves. So then the whole thing was paused again to this current date of October 28th. And in that period, we have been doing these, you know, upstairs you'll see a business and finance presentation, a development and phasing presentation. All those studies were done, are being done. We're still in the middle of it all. To really understand, how do we do the first phase? So a lot of people see the plans and they look different than the final vision and they're saying, where's the final vision? But what this is about is like, just the way I talked about problem opportunity statement, all the phases, getting a preferred alternative, now we're in the sort of beyond that, how do you phase this? If this is really like building an area the size of downtown Toronto, what part do you do first and how do you do it?
Mm-hmm.